Now, I just want to tell you something that is non-nonsense. Like, for example, I just give you initiation. That is never enough, okay? It's not enough. You have to really assimilate the power that has been awakened within you. Yeah?
Yes.
Or transmitted, or awakened, whatever. Yeah. The human language is very complicated. Yeah? It's never really good enough for, I say, metaphysical thing. Yeah? Especially the teaching of heaven. Yeah? All right. So, if you think you can just get initiated and it's all right, it's not. Okay? Of course, you'll be liberated. If you don't commit any grave sin, then you'll be liberated and you'll never see hell. Okay? If you keep to the precept, meditate off and on, or even not, I still help you. But you will not understand much of the other more meaningful teaching to yourself. Yeah? Then you come here or anywhere, you will ask a lot of nonsense. Yeah? And I will have to talk nonsense. And this nonsense are not, you don't even capish. Even if I answer you, you don't capish. For example, in Hungary, I teach you some very deep stuff. And some of you were there, you understood it all. Even though just mentally, you did understand. But the one who has not been there, and the one who has not really into the meditation stuff, maybe you go to group meditation, but you just sit there, daydreaming. Understand me? Or to go there just to get a guy or the girl or the one that you like, or you talk, you like to gossip, then you will not understand what I'm saying, and then you just keep squeezing about things that you don't even know what it is. And you just catch one or two sentences and you dwell on that because you don't understand. Or you understand the wrong way. This is very tiring for me. So, if you don't understand anything about the thought, the thing that I have taught just for disciples, and just be quiet, go home, meditate more, okay? And meditate more, one, two more years, really deep, and you still don't understand it, then please just go out, sell ice cream. Yes, because this will be useless for you. If such a just some mental wrestling, you know, gymnast. Yeah? Even if you understood all what I have told you in Hungary retreat or in London, it's still not the best thing for you yet. The best thing is you, your own wisdom inside, when you are always in deep communion with heaven. Yeah? With the highest teaching of non-verbal education. Otherwise, if you understood me, it's also good for you. At least you don't struggle. Yeah. Who's the master? How is her level? You know? You always worry about my level. Huh? Yeah, one of the disciples, before, you know, we were still talking about 100%, 80%, how many people are enlightened, how many percent, you know, like in Florida. And the guy still asked me, like, if a person like that, you know, well, I don't know if I should tell you. No, did you hear the tape in Florida about how enlightened Jesus was?
Yes.
Okay, then I could tell you. I thought it was just between the group and they open it up. Okay, fine. So I said, Jesus at that time was 80% enlightened. They killed him before he got up. But nevertheless, he's still the Son of God. And his mission only up to there. But he did not die on the cross. Of course, I talk only up to there, okay? And I haven't got a chance to talk later on. And he keep quizzing me, a resident even. If you're only 80%, how can you teach people? But you have to understand how much percent the people at that time. A kindergarten teacher is good enough for a 4-year-old kid. There's no need to bring a professor from university into a kindergarten to tell the kids what's all about. About Einstein and Archimedes, yeah? All kind of Newton, all kind of stuff. They don't compete. Yeah? They don't need to know yet. Okay? They just want to play. Don't you know a simple thing? Like ABC, 1, 2, 3, 4, 2 and 2, 4. Something like that is good enough for the kids. Yeah? So anyway, even if Jesus wasn't 100% enlightened, it's good enough for that time, for them, yeah? How barbarous at that time even. They kill an innocent man who didn't do anything wrong, who didn't even kill anybody, who didn't steal, who did not revolt against the government, who didn't say anything against the government even. Do you understand me? They had no reason, absolutely, lawfully, physically, law speaking, he has committed no citizen crime, yeah? And they just kill him. And barbarous way of killing. At that time, he's too much already for them. He's too high already for them. It's a weight of his spiritual ability, yeah? Spiritual power. But nevertheless, God is always merciful, you know? He sent always the best, all right? Or he sent himself. mostly as a time of deep trouble, he sent himself. Yeah, no one else can take care. So many of the master, when you heard that they tragically die, like the one that I told you the other day, they chop all his limbs and cut his tongue and chop his head. Yes. That was the greatest one. Yeah, of all the Muslim master in that lifetime. For example, hey, only, and Jesus was the greatest one, for example. Buddha was very great, the greatest of that time. Buddha from the fifth level. And the Buddha was 100% enlightened and lived until 80-something years. Buddha is good to teach anybody, yeah? Buddha is great already, yeah? He's from the fifth level and that's the highest you can go. For the human who has already been here, or astral level, or second, intellectual level or third level, fourth level beings, he's great already, yeah? But there are different levels between master, that you know already. So can you understand? If you do not meditate the way I taught you and do not invest your time and sincerity in this pursuit of your higher self, no matter how long I tell you, no matter how long you sit in a group meditation, you gain not much. Yeah, you might gain liberation for yourself and 5 generations, but your level will not be high, okay? Now, there's another way to gain enlightenment also quick, by serving others people, yeah? Some of the people during the retreat, yeah, of course, during the retreat, then you have more concentration on blessing power, that's for sure. And some people who serve very well on the retreat, really selflessly, because maybe at that time he's so happy somebody come, yeah, to his place, he has a chance to meet many people. He's so happy, and he really unconditionally and lovingly serving as much as he can. Then his level goes zip, from second to the fifth. I'm telling you, 3 level. Oh, that's vast. It's not like just 1, 2, 3, we count the fifth level, but we don't know how much lifetime if somebody had to achieve that. So anyway, in that case, he went up very fast. But after that, if he begin to waste his attention on a smaller scale of this spiritual domain, then he lost it so quick. So quick. That's why I don't have any more new Kuan Yin messenger. The level go down so quick after I left, for example, or after the retreat over. The human side of that person came back again, and he swim back into the karma of his sea, of his karmic sea. You understand? Then you get all wet, soaked again in this kind of thinking, this kind of doing. And then his level go down very fast. I have to say that I'm a little bit sad many times. So you guys pay attention to this, okay? The body needs food. The soul, the spirit need meditation power to boost up, okay? To go up. Really, please, even if you are in a mundane environment, you still can keep your mind focused. You still can. If that's all you want, nothing can really distract you. Maybe a little bit, but not too long. Yeah? You have to get to that level so that nothing distracts you anymore. And even if it does, just like dust from your clothes, you shake it and it's gone.